My name is Mark Soucy. I'm the president for Ferroloy, Inc. Ferroloy is a gray and ductile iron foundry located in Wichita, Kansas. We'll make 900 to 1,000 different parts in any one year, across about 55 to 60 different customers. Ferroloy was seeking to apply manufacturing 4.0 technologies as a way to improve our throughput and improve the quality of the castings that we make. We were fortunate to come across Artek at a AFS conference. Part of their presentation was how this could apply to a foundry environment.
My name is Jerry Epler. I am co-founder of Artek Integrated Solutions. Using the Ignition platform, Artek empowers industry professionals by driving significant ROI and efficiency improvements through a commitment to digital transformation, collaboration, and big picture thinking. The goal with the Ferroloy project was to digitally transform their disconnected foundry that relied heavily on manual paper data collection. Through efficient data collection and analysis, the goal was to increase efficiency and reduce scrap by 30%.
One of their analysts, Jim, came from a foundry environment. It was really helpful for us because, you know, he was aware of some of the challenges that we faced.
My name's Jim LaPrat. I work for Artek Integrated Solutions. I'm a design service engineer. Ferroloy's main problems were the data that they were gathering on the floor was siloed from their Hitachi equipment through that software. If you needed that information, you had to walk there to get it. And the same with their other equipment, the spreadsheets and stuff, a lot of that data was literally hand-wrote on paper and then keyed in later into a spreadsheet. Ignition brought the siloed data from their Hitachi and Heraeus equipment directly into screens that could be used on the floor for verification that the product was good at the point it was being used.
I am Clint Van John. I'm a process engineer for Ferroloy. So my role with the project was to serve as the main point of contact on site for the integrator with Artek, as well as develop my own skills within Ignition to serve as an on-site resource. What we're trying to accomplish is to digitize an aged process and gain better visibility to it to unlock the latent potential within the process. Some of the most important features on this project are the simplicity of it. We have a lot of employees out there that are not very tech savvy, some older, and some that there's a language barrier with. The simplicity of it just makes it easy for them to interact with and be able to do what they need to do easily and properly.
Due to the extreme heat needed to liquefy metal, safety is a high priority in a foundry. We wanted to make sure our screens were extremely intuitive and simple as to not distract operators from the potential hazards around them.
So the foundry environment's very harsh on our equipment. We wanted software that could run on equipment that was cheap to replace. With Ignition, we've found that Raspberry Pis or just a regular smart TV is sufficient for what we need to do in a lot of cases.
One of the problems with foundries is that they're inherently dusty and displays generally don't last very long in those environments. Using the perspective module, we were able to create KPIs that can be displayed on inexpensive dashboards over the line that can be replaced without extreme costs.
A lot of our equipment out there is different vintages and different ages, different PLCs, and then there's other types of equipment that don't communicate via PLC. So we had to find ways to communicate with all of it. We've yet to find a limitation that Ignition hasn't been able to overcome.
Their mold machines were using a Mitsubishi PLC, which at the time Inductive had it in beta. We used their Mitsubishi driver for testing and then rolled it out as soon as it was released.
The team at Ferroloy also implemented some manual push buttons to help us collect counts on some of the more manual processes. We were also able to connect Ignition to their Odyssey ERP system to push and pull shop order data.
Connecting and pulling data from their ERP system was a cornerstone in this project so that the data didn't have to be entered again someplace else and copied and pasted. We literally pulled it down live from the cloud, local, to display it on the screens and use it where needed.
We have this sand system. It tests the quality of our sand. And it doesn't operate the way we'd like it to operate. So what we've done is we've worked with that vendor and learned the different tags. And now what Clint was able to do was build a routine that's grabbing a tag on setting the priority on when the sand is going to be delivered, where it's going to be delivered. Then once the sample is taken and if it meets our spec, it's going to get delivered to that mold machine. And then it sends it back to the system. Now, we can't write on the system, the vendor's system, but Ignition was so flexible that we were able to just figure out the tags so that it basically is going around some of the functionality of the system.
Ignition is currently used in Ferroloy across the plant, from plant floor to upper management. Everybody's touched it, used it in some capacity.
At Ferroloy, we have about 70 employees, and about 45 of those employees are in the foundry. And at any one time on a shift, there'll be about five people that are actually engaged in the system. There'll be our iron pourers, there'll be our furnace operator, there'll be our charge hand, there'll be a lab tech that are actually interacting with the HMIs. And then we'll have our mold operators that are engaging the system by being on the machine, because Ignition is wired in to our mold machine. We have several displays that are visible, and people are making decisions on what's going on in the facility by monitoring and making decisions based on what they see on the displays.
With Ignition implemented there, their efficiency across the plant has been much smoother. The data's quickly gathered and visualized so that they know where to go and what to do next.
Things are different now with Ignition. With Ignition, we're able to see more or less up to the minute production data, whereas before we would lag behind by a week or so. We feel more confident in our data. We believe it's more accurate than it used to be, as well as being faster. So we're able to identify trends, shift reports, and that type of thing can come out almost in real time. Those have been huge improvements and have allowed us to identify and more quickly react to problems.
With the implementation of Ignition, I can see real time, you know, where we're at during in the day in terms of how much iron we poured, how many molds we've made, and how the quality of our sand. And so as we kind of look forward over the next several months, I can only imagine the level of knowledge and information I'll have available at my fingertips, not only in the foundry, but even into our machine shop, which is something that we'll be adding to our system in the future.
Ignition is already expanding into other areas of the plant. As we speak, they're working on integrating their QA lab into Ignition. In fact, they're actually building the screens right in Ignition instead of using some of the screens that existed before with some of that analysis equipment. We're getting spectrometer data into Ignition now. And on top of that, now we're starting to work on getting some of the grinding room data into Ignition, and also working on dashboards for the break room and things like that.
When we implemented Ignition, we found that the more we used it, the more uses we could find for it. I think the future is very bright for it. We see a lot of uses for it, and there's plenty of development for us to go.
Ferroloy's benefit moving forward would be that the Ignition system does not pin them down with licensing costs and scalability issues. With the unlicensed model, they can expand as much as they need. The scalability, they can expand to more VMs, connect to more data.
The truth is that a lot of other foundries are looking for something like what we've implemented for Ferroloy, and they just don't know where to start. And Mark was in the exact same position, and thankfully he found us right when he was beginning this journey, and we helped guide him through this process to really take the ideas that he had and the opportunities that he knew were there and really bring them to fruition.
Pursuing innovative solutions is very important for a foundry like Ferroloy. We're a smaller business, a smaller foundry. It's difficult for us to compete with some of the bigger ones. So having these innovative solutions to these problems and making our jobs easier is very important and helps give us a competitive edge and operate more efficiently.
For foundries that are in a similar position to Ferroloy, I would encourage them to not be discouraged with the potential unknowns. The time invested and the resources invested into these projects pay for themselves many times over in a relatively short period of time. I would encourage foundries like Ferroloy to lean on integrators like Artek, who have worked with metal casters and know how to implement these sorts of systems, integrating all different types of equipment, their ERP systems, and things like that to really get real value out of these sorts of projects.
For a foundry our size, this is really something pretty unique. You've got to have somebody that has a vision and a willingness to allocate resources to go down this path. I just felt that it was the right thing for us to do, not only for our owners, but for our customers, to be able to have confidence in Ferroloy as a supplier for the future. Like most companies, I mean, we're constantly trying to become more efficient or expand capacity or reduce waste in our system. And we think that that type of culture is required to be a long-term solution for our customers. We view both inductive automation and Artek as partners to our success. And so it's been a terrific relationship and partnership as we move forward.